The aviation industry is currently responsible for about 2% of global greenhouse gas emissions, and this figure is set to grow. Airports have carbon footprint as well due to the infrastructure that they manage. On the top of managing their own emissions, airports can positively influence emissions from flights. That is why today we're here in Heathrow to learn which sustainability practices the airport is using. The work of reducing emissions is actually happening behind the scenes, so regular travelers cannot really see it. So today I'm gonna take you with me so you can see it as well. So our first stop of the tour is here at the parking lot. So here at Heathrow, they provide electric vehicle charging points for all the cars that arrive to the airport, because obviously when you drive a car, there are emissions that are emitted in our atmosphere. So Heathrow is trying to reduce that as well by providing those charging points. Heathrow has those amazing, really futuristic Heathrow pods that are absolutely autonomous. So there's no driver, they just drive themselves. Welcome to the future, guys. Okay, guys, so safety first, vests are on. We're ready to go to the air control tower. Let's go. The air traffic control tower is handling 1,350 aircrafts every single day. And right now we're gonna go to the top to see which sustainability practices are implemented here. Guys, we're on the top of the air control tower, and this is literally the coolest place I've ever been. No kidding. Heathrow has invested over £100 million in sustainability transformation and is aiming to be carbon neutral by 2020. All right, guys, who wants to know a fun fact? Actually, all Virgin Atlantic planes have cute names, and this one over there is called Miss Sunshine. There is a fuel tank farm behind me, and fuel is supplied to the aircraft by underground pipes. Literally, how cool is it? I cannot get over it. Oh my God, that was amazing. My mind is blown away. I literally thought that the guys would be like really stressed, you know, like the vibe would be like, oh my God, like panicky. But no, everyone is like so chilled and at the same time really collected. It was amazing. I don't think I would be able to do something like that, but I really appreciate people who can do that. So those tiny cute cars are used to transport your luggage into the plane. And guess what? They are electric as well. There's preconditioned air inside those yellow pipes. It's basically going inside the aircraft to save the fuel. The engines are not running while the pipes are connected to the aircraft. So good. So much information. It's really hard to digest everything. My mind is blown away. I am so excited to learn more. We are in Terminal 2 that is operated on 100% renewable electricity and heating. And everything here is designed to save electricity. Like, look at those natural lights. Also, all the lights are replaced with LEDs. By ensuring recycling and water refill stations are easy accessible. Having a tour on the top of the roof of Terminal 2. By operating on 100% renewable electricity that is produced by 124 solar panels that are located on its roof, biomass boiler and renewable gas. There are 10,000 commercial planes all in the air at the same time at any given point. All right, so we finally got a moment to sit down and relax a little bit after a crazy day. And we're here at the restaurant that is serving sustainable fish. And I'm gonna try the local fish and chips. By becoming the world's first sustainable fish restaurant. Mmm, so good. One day we might be able to travel the world in emission-free planes completely powered by renewable energy. But unfortunately, that day is not today. However, we should support changes big and small within aviation and encourage airlines to continue developing technologies. And Heathrow is doing their part by providing them with cleaner energy on stand, improving landing and takeoff cycles, facilitating access to sustainable aviation fuels. Here's how you can help as well. Reduce unnecessary flying, travel overland when you can, and explore your own background. When you do fly, choose non-stop flights and support airlines that are committed to sustainable alternatives. Offset your carbon emissions. Learn about the work that your local airport is doing to reduce the emissions and support it by being a conscious traveler. Right guys, so our tour came to an end. Thank you so much for being here with me. I definitely learned so much about the industry and I'm so excited for more changes, for more sustainable changes to be implemented.